Oh, fire and brimstone and driving knees in the midfield. Got BC. Oh, he's through, he's away. He's got Varney in the banana yellow boots on the inside. And no one will catch him now. The stands erupt in Treviso. There's a World Cup in 2 weeks' time and Italy look bang up for it. It feels as though we've scarcely seen the Japanese up this end of the field. It's Horier to Leach, to Horier. Lovely wraparound pass, driving over the line is Naya Kambula. A third try in only 4 caps.
That was definitely a special play. That was pre-planned. We'll see it in the minute now. Here we go. We throw it in, and as they come down, Italy think they're coming to set up the maul. 9 goes round on the blind side, takes the prop with them, and then leaves a space who would be defending the tail at the back.
They also stole 5 of Samoa's line out in the opening match of their Pacific Nations campaign. So it's clearly something they've been working hard on. It's Italy, though, now, who begin to make inroads.
Okay, use it now, please.
Shunt by shunt, grunt by grunt. And it's a wide pass from Varney. One hand pass out the back door. Now, IOANE. Here is Allen with space. Frees a hand, finds Capuozzo. The stadium's on its feet. He chips it up over the top. IOANE now chases. Who will gather this one? Oh, it's the Italian. Scintillating stuff from the Azzurri. What a curler.
I think it was IOANE that actually got it down. It'll be interesting to see what the ref really gives it. Look, he starts off that pass, you know, he creates a 2-on-1, offload out the tackle, Capuozzo down the wing, and so smart to kick back and field. The only way he was going was going to be tackled and touch, so he puts it in field and lets IOANE chase that down.
And also, Nagare, the Japanese scrum half, he's only 5'5". The mismatch was there. The fullback, just his 4th start in that position on the international stage, but taking that, plucking that from the skies like someone who's played it for years. Oh, here we go. Got BC with plenty of work to do. Osada, the prodigious young inside centre for Japan, piling pressure on the fly half, and it's Japan's penalty. We're back where we were moments ago. An opportunity, which he executes, for him to get some confidence back.
Yeah, absolutely, and that's the trust that the captain's putting in him.
A man nearing 50 outings for the Azzurri. He's been in this position before. It's Nicolò Cannone, the Benetton
right,
lock.
Right, entering, 7.
Born in Florence,
number
but
seven,
now
entering.
Plying his trade in the engine room. And Italy have a free hit here. There's an advantage. Everyone is out on the open side. They'll look to spread it wide. Oh, no, up the middle it goes. Morisi on an incisive direct line. Okay. And now this is Fischetti. Straight into the melee on pitch after his early introduction, earlier than he will have been expecting, but doesn't bat an eyelid. Varney, try scorer half an hour ago. And Italy chipping and chiselling away at the defensive line.
I've got it held up.
But it's held up. Fine work by the Japanese.
We have 2 penalties. 2 penalties in front, 1 offside, or 7 side entry over there.
Scoring, of course, against the box in Brighton in 2015. That miraculous, miraculous day. The clock is red, and here come the men in that colour.
Playing the 9, not you. 9. Playing the 9. Playing the 9, not you.
Yeah, so Lamaro is right quite capable to go for the middle, but what he cannot do is he can't touch the 9. He can't stop the 9 from passing, as we'll see.
Shot.
Gone through. Shot. We'll see here. Next.
You're
goes to pick
fine.
It up. Lamaro will come through
you
in
come
a second.
Come through and then you grab the 9.
And play the 9.
No. You grab the 9, he's coming to play the ball.
Nicotera returns. BG can go and cool off for a little bit. The man they call Il Mulo, because he is as stubborn as a mule.
On the way in.
Trucks it up, fastidious, tireless, relentless. It's not the sexiest of nicknames, but I think in a front rower, mule qualities, well, they're well worth having. And this, for Lee, the greatest test of his boot so far. One from three, but all from much closer than this effort. Well, it's definitely got the distance. Oh, well, when it's tricky, when it's tough, Sung Chun Lee steps up and delivers. The gap is narrowed as the sides head to the sheds here at the Stadio Comunale di Monigo. Jamie Joseph, implacable. Wonder what he'll be saying to his side. They trail Italy by 11 points to 17 after a highly entertaining opening 40. Tries from Varney, tries from Ioane and Naya Kambula. A handful of penalties too. Don't go anywhere because this has been pretty sparky and it'll be right back in a moment. Masirewa lurking right on the touchline before our commentary gantry. Ball is messy, bricks flying up. Oh, it's Matsushima who will score! Huh? Well, you asked for patience, Sarah. There it was, Japan 17 phases before the killer blow from their fullback.
Yeah, Italy defended their line really, really well, but Japan just kept coming and coming, and sometimes, like, the ball obviously didn't mean to bounce and it was an error in the quality of pass, but sometimes that just catches the defence and it caused them to stop. We'll see there, it bounces.
Just tell your
13
nine.
Flies out the line,
every
creates that disconnect, and Matsushima is right in there to get those points for Japan.
Japan changing both their props, but Horie staying out there. We know that he's got real staying power. Back in 2019, he played all 80 against Ireland in that famous win, and then all but 7 minutes against Scotland in Yokohama.
Knock on.
Wonder if he'll go the distance tonight. Fischetti.
No!
Red boots. Whirring as he's tackled, but it takes a couple of attempts. Now Ioane, lovely little tip pass. Morisi, Lamaro, ball hits the deck, but Capuazzo has it. Scampering inside, finding the outside man. Now Ioane, will he have his second? Italy bites back immediately. They know the power of momentum and they are determined to back up last week's win against Romania. It's a try and a popular one too.
Yeah, the Italian crowd like that, don't they? Just great rugby, you know, they've gone out the back there, out the back again. That offload out the tackle, just soft hands against that bouncing ball, stops the defence. But the back inside ball, the flooding that all the players are doing to stay onside, to be the little support line runners for the attackers in case they get that offload about, it's such great play from Italy.
See them all good, Stuart.
Varney really had to rootle around for that one. And such is the Japanese line speed that Italy find themselves going backwards at risk now of exiting the 22. Zuliani, who had such a coming-of-age performance against Scotland at Murrayfield earlier on in these warm-ups, started at open side that day and retained that jersey against Ireland ahead of Michele Lamaro. He's got a really bright future ahead of him, as does Dino Lam. In the colours of the Azzurri, the former England under 20. Now playing for the Italians and scored a try last week on just his second outing in blue and white.
Advantage.
And now Italy have a chance to really lay their cards on the table. There's the advantage.
12 red.
Japan were offside. Osada, that is. Stay down. So we'll come back. The flags go up, as does the volume up to Stadio Comunale di Monigo. digging away, scraping away. They opt for the short and direct option. Italy, though, do really well to bring down the hard, direct running of the Japanese. Again, they come, Vailu. And they're not going forwards, the Blossoms. They're going laterally here. Options either side, but it's the blind that they opt for. Inagaki carrying now. There's a witch. Oh, there's a witch. And there's the try. It's Dylan Riley with just his second try in the colours of Japan. And the gap narrows right as 10 minutes remain on the clock. A grandstand finish beckons in Treviso.
Yeah, you can see Japan here just going through the phases. They're punching hard through the middle. The Italy defence have to tighten up, which gives Riley some space further out on the edge. Look at the power that he creates to beat through, power through two Italian defenders, get his arms free to ensure that the try goes down.
That's watching sport in a nutshell right there. Ecstasy and agony. And this, for Akia Matsuda, a big kick. Time to find his first accurate strike of the evening. It has let them down so badly tonight.
Nine, five.
They're running out of time. And here they come. But it's regathered by IOANE, the man on two tries, hunting for a hat-trick. Oh, he's managed to wriggle free. Oh, what IOANE is having an absolute field day. Look at what it means to him. A hat-trick hero headed for the World Cup.
Not a bad way to sign off your pre-season, is it? Heading into the Rugby World Cup, scoring three tries, full of confidence. He's had a great game. Just a kick, like Japan are probably trying it, probably not the right thing to do there. IOANE in space, in an unstructured defence, is chaos, and he showed that when Japan aren't in a defensive organisation, he's cutting through at loose shoulders, stepping off one foot, Yukiwi will step off the other foot, have a little fend, and he's in under the post.
Come up.
Gunter lending all of his heft and his brawn to that carry. Ball's loose. Oh, it's pounced upon. Martin Pajarello has it. What a moment for the replacement scrum half. All the guile and all the pace in the world, and a try on just his second cap.
Yeah, he did well to anticipate it. That's a real poacher's try from a winger right there. Japan just trying to play, you know, just trying to force that extra pass. Rugby World Cup warm-up game, have nothing to lose, to keep trying things, but ultimately probably just forced it a little bit too much. Bounce the ball, Pajarello picks it up, goes in behind, great pick-up, and then no one's catching him after that.
Thank you.
Just a loose pass, you know, and then not able to keep a hold of it by Masi Reiwa.
He's been described by Toa Halafihi as an absolute rocket, and we saw all of that firepower. That was the pace. The poise was from Tommaso Allen. He adds the conversion.
Thank you.
And it's back-to-back wins for the Italians right before they head to France in search of history. Treviso treated to a bucket load of tries and some scintillating rugby. And Kieran Crowley treated to a win in his final match on Italian soil as head coach. They head to Toulouse. The Japanese, they have some questions to answer. There were moments of brilliance, of audacity, of courage, but also heaps of inaccuracy. For the Italians, what a boost. There are giants lurking in their pool. They'll need to beat one of Les Bleus and the All Blacks, but tonight they will celebrate a significant beaming victory. It's full-time in Treviso. Italy 42, Japan 41. Next stop, the World Cup.